Welcome to Sitka, Alaska. My name is Emily Noyd, and I came to Sitka National Historical Park as an intern for the Climate Change Youth Initiative. My job was to do science-based communication at a historical park with primarily cultural resources. The project's title was Small Park, Big Resources. Little did I know, the title described exactly the dilemma that smaller parks are facing. How can we communicate climate change? Do our visitors care? It was pretty tough conducting field projects in Russian period clothing. Just kidding. Most days, I wore waders and spent time monitoring the park's Indian River. The salmon that spawn in this river year after year are the keystones of the ecosystem. Their presence provides nutrients to other organisms and the surrounding environment, not to mention their vital role in Sitka economically and culturally. One aspect of my internship was to explore how these living representations of Sitka are being threatened. I conducted research on the river and contributed to a longer-term data collection effort. We got up close and personal with salmon while measuring stream flow and determining the health of their habitat. Understanding how much water is flowing through the river tells us a lot about the snowmelt and rain that feed the river each season. Thousands of salmon come home to the Indian River, and its water level is at a crucial tipping point for supporting the strong runs that we saw this year. Another project we worked on was collecting dead salmon and determining if they had strayed from the nearby hatchery in an effort to spawn. We collected the salmon's ear bones, called otoliths, which would be thermally marked to indicate a hatchery fish. After beheading 100 salmon, I am officially an expert at otolith extraction. One of my other projects was water quality monitoring for factors like pH, temperature, and dissolved oxygen, all really important in understanding the salmon habitat. I monitored bat activity, looked for invasive green crabs, collected mussels, and helped with a fish contaminant study too. The other part of my job was science outreach, communicating what I learned to our visitors. Most important is what I learned from them. Visitors care deeply about these special places. They're curious, concerned, and hopeful about climate change. Website updates, table talks about salmon, and evening programs all help start the climate change conversation. With exceptional weather and a great group of coworkers, I managed to fit in some fun outside too. There's nothing like being on top of a peak to help you put all the projects into perspective. These patches of snow literally feed our river. These surrounding landscapes keep the park healthy and alive. Sitka has undergone a lot of changes, but perhaps the most significant change is now upon us, climate change. I didn't understand before what big resources a small park could have. Not necessarily literally, but in their role as a platform for teaching about climate change. I'm confident other interpreters nationwide will answer the call for action I hear so loudly. No matter a park's size or resources, I feel strongly that this topic can and must be communicated everywhere. This internship has taught me that climate change must be a phrase in every interpreter's vocabulary. I will continue pursuing my passion for environmental studies and education at the University of Washington, and never forget the lessons that Sitka and its inhabitants, human, salmon, or otherwise, have taught me.